Sheep of a soul, Shepherd of a soul,
Savior of a soul, Lover of a soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcomers, for the Lord God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We
word of exhortation this morning before titled the contentment is godly contentment. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Godly contentment. Amen. If we go by the definition of the word contentment, what is contentment? In other words, contentment simply means to be satisfied, to be contented, to be self contented. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. But these days we see that people are beginning to undermine the contentment of God in their life. Please talk me to the book of 1 Timothy chapter 6. I read from verses 6 to 11. 1 Timothy chapter 6 from verse 6 to 11. I read in Jesus' name. But godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we carry nothing out. Praise the Lord. And verse 8 says, and having food and raiment, let us be therewith content. 9. But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, into many foolish and harmful lusts, which draw men in destruction and perdition. 10. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which why some converted after they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrow. 11. But thou, O man of God, flee from these things, and follow after righteousness and godliness, faith, love, peace, patience, and meekness. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Brethren, according to our brother, peace will say that everything that is written for our own learning. They are for time. God this morning is telling you and I that godly contentment is gain. Godly contentment is what you and I need at this end time. Godly contentment is what will make us to make heaven. Praise the Lord. Today we see people, they're not saying that what God has done or what God has created or what God has blessed them with is nothing. That is why today people are now going into diverse way of trying to get themselves, you know, things that will bring them, you know, to perdition, things that will bring them to destruction. Today you can see people of the world today, they will tell you, their complexion, which God created them with, is not enough. So they go about now using chemical to bleach themselves, to peel their skin, and thereby causing, you know, havoc, causing harm to their own body. At the end, they're looking for medical solutions on how to remedy what they have used their hand to destroy. Praise the Lord. But this morning, The word of God is telling you and I that godly contentment is gain. God has so much loved us that he created us after his own image and likeness. But today, people of the world are now saying, oh, God has made mistake for creating them, for them to be who they are. Today, they want to be glorified. They said, I'm sorry to bring this in. We all knew what happened to a popular, you know, world musician, Michael Jackson, who said the faith God gave to him was something wrong, and thereby going to do, you know, a plastic transplant. At the end, it led him to destruction, and today he's crying in hell. Praise the Lord. And for those of us that live today, we knew that, oh, my hairstyle is totally off. We go to a salon and get it, you know, burned down. You see, for today, they bat their hair, you know, like the cock head. They blow to one side, and you have their all over their body, you know, marked with hole. Their mouth, their tongue, their eye, everywhere is full of, you know, hole, trying to make themselves beautiful, creating themselves an idol before God that created them. Praise the Lord. But the Lord is telling this one that whatsoever he has given to us, we should be contented with it. Because it is only by so doing that we will have peace. A man that is using chemical to clean himself will always look for more chemical to remedy what he has done, the damage he has done to his body, and will always look for one way or the other to make sure that he remains who he wants to be. But by so doing, he will be incurring more pain, more sorrow, and more destruction to himself while living. Mm-hmm. I wonder where or what will happen to him when he dies. Praise the Lord. So, brethren, the word of God is yet an amen. God had not made a mistake right from creation. He knew who we are before we were created. He knew what will benefit us, what will make us be happy before we were ever created by him. Praise the Lord. Please turn with me to the book of Psalm 37. I will read verses 3 to 5 and also read verse 16. Praise the Lord. Verse 3 said, trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. For they delight themselves also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desire of thy heart. 5. Commit thy way into the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. The Lord. But these days, instead of we to commit our ways or to delight in the things of God, we prefer to have ourselves committed to the hands of the devil, for the devil to manipulate, to deal with people, you know, mercilessly, even before they are sent to hell. Today, people no longer, you know, want to hear anything concerning, you know, godliness and holiness or righteousness about the things of God. All they want to do is they want to fashion their way out. And the way the Bible said, there's a way that seems righteous unto man, but unto destruction. Praise the Lord. So this day, people prefer to follow that way that lead to destruction than to obey the simple instruction of God. God has made this life, this world, so simple for every one of us. But today, we are now using our hand to draw, you know, things that are not supposed to be, to hinder our life. We are now saying what God has created to be, or what God has concerning us, is nothing but the will of the devil is what we pray to do. And thereby, at the end, they run from place to post. They now start running. Those ones that want to also repent, they start looking for men of God, and even so-called looking for men of God, they also go about looking for the men of God in the wrong way, going to prophets who are demonic agents. A sister once confessed that they do something, and they will also, you know, instruct people. They will blend their eye, they will blend their mind on where to go, and also they go again to their own demonic agent for solution, thereby leading them more into hellfire. I pray that this morning, God Almighty will help you and I that will be contented with God has given us or what God has called us to be from the creation of the world in Jesus' mighty name.
He said,
a little that a righteous man had is better than the riches of many wicked. A little that God has given you, that little thing, that little treasure God has treasured you, is better than you running after the wicked way of the devil. The devil might give you 5 cents, but they are going to take your entire life from you. Praise the Lord. I pray that God Almighty, as the word of God come day after day on this mountain, that we will be careful enough or be intelligent enough to know that God desire, better living, good life, good environment for you and I, that we might not be a prey in the hand of the enemy on the last day. Because whatsoever devil has given you now, on the last day, you are going to pay daily for it. You are going to, the end up is hellfire, a place of no return, a place where there's no coming back again to testify or to say what you have gone through in their hand. I pray that God Almighty will help us all in Jesus' mighty name. Turn to the book of Luke chapter 12. I read 15, Luke 12, 15, praise the Lord. And he said unto them, take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisted not in the abundance of the things which he had possessed. A man's life is not, worthy, it's not confined by the riches or whatever he had. What is your spiritual gain? Where will you end your eternity? That is most important to a man. We knew also today in the world, at the time, Abiola was the richest man in Africa, Parker in the Pacific, so on and so forth. Gaddafi in Libya, today where are they? Abacha, Nigeria, today where are they? They are all dancing that dance of no return in hellfire because they were never satisfied with what God had given them. Praise the Lord. So this morning, beloved, even the so-called men of God that we are looking upon yesterday, those that have died, today where are they? Because of the care of this world, because of covetousness, because of trying to be who God had not created to be. A pastor want to hold the whole of Germany. The car will outnumber that of the head of state. These are all vanity upon vanity. God is telling you and I this morning that one trouser, that one shirt. He has given you that one pair of shoes. He has given you. Be contented with it, and by so doing, you will, avoid the rot of the devil on the last day. But today, what do we see? A Christian man or woman want to be the most adored person in her vicinity, in his area, which is not of God. And today, there are so many people, widows, so many left privileged, the orphanage, they are all roaming, the street of the church. But nobody cares about them. What we are after is me. And so doing, we go about, in curing the wrath of God upon ourselves. But the word of God is telling you this morning, that those things are of no use to him. All he wants us to be, God is not delighted in the condemnation of any soul on the last day. All he wants us to be is to come to his rest and say, thank you, Daddy, for all that we passed through, for how I will overcome what we went through in the hands of this world. That is his desire for us all. But today, we are saying God has made a mistake. I pray that God forgive all of us all in Jesus' name. Then we are called him, by first day we are called him liar. Anybody has called God liar must go to hellfire. There's two about it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And Isaiah chapter 23, verse 3 is telling us this morning. He said, by the great waters, the seed of Sihor, the harvest of the river is her revenue. It's her revenue. And she is a mart of nation. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. Amen. What I want to do is Isaiah 26, verse 3. Say, thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stored in thee, because he trusted in thee. Brethren, let us put our trust in the Lord. He is the only perfect peace. He is the only will. He is the only righteous God. He is the only God that have our word, that had our feelings in his heart. That's why he sent the Lord Jesus Christ to come and die for you and I, that we might be able to be redeemed, to be called his children, his chosen one. As he said, Israel, my firstborn, that we will remain the firstborn he has called us from the creation of the world unto eternity. Praise the Lord. Amen. That is the only way that we can be sure of the last day. We can be sure of entering into eternity on the last day. But rather, people have chosen today to fight their way out. They want to live like the people who said the world belongs to them, that without they, the world is incomplete. No problem. According to the word of the watchman, said no problem. On the last day, we will know who owns the world. We will know who was the righteous man or who was the right or where the righteous man was born in our life. Praise the Lord. Please talk to the book of, I read Proverbs chapter 30, verses 8 and 9. Proverbs 30, verses 8 and 9, I read in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
8 and 9, I read, it said, remove far from me vanity and lies. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Feed me with food convenient for me. 9. Lest I be fooled and deny thee and say, who is the Lord? Or lest I be poor and steal and take the name of my God in vain. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The word of God this morning is telling you and I that all we need is the little food that will take us, you know, all the long, the peace of God that will surpass every human understanding, you know, the healing of God upon our life. That's all we need. Needless of we condemn ourselves before the eternal condemnation. But today, the house of God, you might find, you know, 100,000 people sitting in the church, and at the end, two are not even guaranteed of doing the will of God among that 100,000. Is that what God has called us to be? No. We should be contented with what God has blessed us with. That is the only way he will be happy with us. That is the only way he will be regarded as his children. It's not going to make a church that matters. It's not going to, you know, to edifice to go and worship God that matters. But your relationship with God, your heart with God, is what God is after. Praise the Lord. It's not the multitude, but the little ones that are doing the will of God is whom he's delighted upon, is whom he called his children. And the last day, those are the ones that will make heaven and go to stress in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
So then, let us be contented with what God has blessed us with. Let us be satisfied. Let us live in harmony with one another. Let us begin to see ourselves as brother and sister. Let us begin to emulate the framework that Lord Jesus Christ has laid for us all to follow. I'm also doing, he will be glad with us, and who will live a peaceful and honorable life unto eternity in Jesus' mighty name.
Yeah.
Please open to the book of Matthew chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6, I will read from 19 to 24, and verse 3 is a very popular verse in this ministry that we all know very well. Matthew chapter 6, I will read 19 to 24. Praise the Lord.
Right.
19 says, it said, lay not up yourself treasures upon earth, where moth and rust do it corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal them. Praise the Lord. 20. But lay up yourself treasure in heaven, where neither moth nor rust do it corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. 21. Say, for where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. 22. Say, the light of the body is the eye. If therefore the eye be single, why whole body shall be full of light. 23. Say, but if thy eyes be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness? Praise the Lord. Today, so many eyes have led the people that owns it into destruction or not to them. And they think they are wise. They are doing right. They are happy. But the end justifies the means. Amen. So please let our eyes be the eye of God upon our body. Let us begin to see things the way the Lord God Almighty sees it. And that is the only way we can be guaranteed of heaven. If today a Christian man is still going, gallivanting himself, roaming everywhere, looking for things that will bring total internal condition to his body, what is the essence of going to church? You better go to the little doctor and remain with them and be one of them, so that we know, or everybody know, who you are or where you belong to, and not disguising under the coverage of Christian, and even worse than the so-called herbalist on the street. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And verse 24 said, he said, no man can serve two masters, for either he will hate one and love the other, nor else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. Anybody that is not satisfied with God has created him or her with, is not serving God but serving mammon. Praise the Lord. And verse 3 said, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto thee. If you serve God very well, you obey his commandment, obey his will, everything shall come to place. You will not, according to what the man of God has always said, God has not promised me, I will give you a private jet. I will give you, the whole world. But what I know is that you will not lack anything in my presence. Praise the Lord. Anybody serving God will not go hungry. He will not be neglected. He will not be, a beggar. He will be satisfied. God will ensure that from day to day, there is something on your table that people will not come and begin to mock you or ridicule you. That is the essence of our living in Christ Jesus. Every other thing is vanity. So let us be contented. Let us be safe. Let us put ourselves into that proper holiness and righteousness, that God has created of it, that at the end, people will even see you and begin to ask you, how are you doing it? Praise the Lord. Everything today in the world, there's no problem today in the world that is not caused by man, because of our insatisfiable desire. I pray that God Almighty will help you, will help me, will help everyone of us this morning in Jesus' mighty name. That at the end, His name will glorify in our life in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. But then, because of time this morning, I just want to take Proverbs chapter number 19. Praise the Lord. I read Proverbs 19 from verses 23. The glory of God in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Proverbs 19, I read verse 23. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 23 said, amen. Then the fear of the Lord tender to life, and he that had it shall abide satisfied. He shall not be visited with evil. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Any man or woman that is satisfied with what God has created him or her with will not be visited by the evil. Praise the Lord. Because by time we now try to say, I don't think that what God has given me is enough. Let me go and look for more. That is where evil thought, that is where evil devices, that is where evil manipulation or pressure comes in. I pray that God Almighty will gather this morning, that we all will satisfy what we go have created with, that evil will not know our ways in Jesus' mighty name. Because today, most of these sicknesses, most of these affliction, most of the things we see today, they are being caused by we ourselves, because we are trying to diversify what God has not created us with. By so doing, we now start inviting evil to ourselves. I pray that as we hear the word of God this morning, God will help you, God will help me, God will help all of us, that evil will not know our way, evil will not come our way in Jesus' mighty name, but to be satisfied with what God has created us with in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Please, on our own, we can read Philippians chapter 4, verses 11 to 12, and verse 19 we know, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5, and Isaiah 5 verse 8. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Amen. Brethren, this is the word of God for you, for me, and for everyone of us this morning. And I pray that God Almighty will help us and bless us all in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
What is the man of God?
This was a talk about.
Okay. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Brethren, are you here this morning? And you have not yet given your life to Jesus Christ. There is no way you can be satisfied with God's contentment. You always look for a means of satisfying yourself or trying to get yourself contented from anywhere. And so doing, you are the one we're talking about this morning. So are you here this morning? You want to give your life to Christ? Please say after me, because God is delighted in every single soul that is repented of his sin according to him. Heaven will rejoice with you this morning, as we all of this ministry will also rejoice with you for taking the right decision this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So if you had this, you want to give your life to Christ, say after me. Lord Jesus, please have mercy upon me in any way I have converted, worldly, in any way I have converted unknown to me. Have mercy upon me, deliver me, let my name be wiped away from the book of death, and let it be written in the book of life, to be honor of your name, in Jesus' mighty name. Please, Daddy, watch me this morning with your precious blood, the blood that was shed for the remission of my sin, that I be regarded as one of your chosen ones unto eternity, in Jesus' mighty name. Have you made a declaration this morning, my beloved? I pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord, my God, that you behold your daughter, your son, that have decided to return back to this morning as the progress son. Father, have mercy upon him or her. That Lord, wipe away their name from the book of death, and let their names be written in the book of life to give an honor for them. That on the last day, they will not be cast away, but they will all come to your rest and have their eternal rest in your bosom, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for assembling these ones in your presence. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
But then let us quickly take one prayer for this morning. In many ways, we have despised the covenant of God in our life. In any way, we have said to do it the wrong way. In any way, we have gone after the will of God, knowing or learning. This morning, we will pray for mercy that will have mercy upon us and return us back to His glorious destiny this morning. In Jesus' name, we will pray.
Father,
forgive us, Lord. Forgive our brothers and sisters, our parents, Lord, our loved ones, our entire household. Father, ask for forgiveness, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for listening, because I'm God that stood to anger, but quit the mercy in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father, to you be the glory and honor. All that belong to you, for in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed for mercy.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What is that?